Easter 2010. The Easter egg hunt is over. I say nay nay. Now there's gonna be an envelope hunt. Let me show you. Isabella. Sabrina. Tiny Madalena. Alyssa. Gianna. Julian. Vincenzo. Gabriella. And Maria's fetus. Achtun, achtun, listen up. Even though the Easter egg hunt is over, there's still another hunt. This, listen, instructions are following. There are envelopes with money in them. There are envelopes with money. And all your names are spelled wrong. So if you get an envelope and it's not yours, you have to help the other person find them. It's very easy. All the envelopes are right in this area. So go ahead, scram and find some envelopes. Find the envelopes. Come on, it's easy. They're all like right there. Come on, it's easy. You got money? Nice. Is that yours?
That's not how you spell my name. C-I-N-C-E-N-Z.
I know, it was joke spelling. Happy Easter, Gabriella.
Thank you. Thank you.
You're welcome, sweetheart. You counting your money, Julian? Oh, they're going wild. I feel bad for her future husband. Give me all your money.
I need dollars for the meal. Everybody's got to pay for their dinner.
When I went to the bank and requested $100 in singles, they thought I was going to the strip joint.
Oh, I can believe that.
Yes, happy Easter. And you made a leg of lamb.
A leg of lamb.
We're going to see that. We're all going to eat that. It's all good. Okay. For all the animal rights activists out there, I'm sorry. What animal did you kill, Rich?
That's a beef.
It's a beef? The animal is called a beef?
A cow. A moo.
Okay. Rosie O'Donnell. Alex, what are you doing?
I'm trying to clog arteries tonight.
You're making the gravy?
Yeah.
Is it you putting starch in it or thickening it up?
Thickening it up, baby.
Nice. Dave,
hey.
Inbound Logistics, you help with the table.
Yeah, things are gonna work out.
I like the layout. It's good. It's a U. Is there something special here, Madeline?
Yes.
Something special?
It is. I just took my hair down for the special
production.
We're having free Christmas dish entree because we ran out of dishes. We have too many people.
You ran out of dishes? I want one of those.
What is this for Alfred? Yeah. That's his name on it. Alfred.
Nice. I promise not to break it, really. We're now on the test set of the new season of Miami Vice. I'm trying to think of a plot situation here now.
We're studying our lines right now.
Mike's undercover. And we got a hot babe undercover trying to bust up that drug ring down at Sistrunk Street.
Sistrunk. Miami Vice just moved to Fort Lauderdale. It's Fort Lauderdale Vice.
There you go. I'm sure there's a lot of Vice down there,
this
too.
This is the sequel to that.
Sabrina, can I ask you something?
Mm-hmm.
What are you guys doing on that table over there? Can you show me?
I'm digging some leafage.
You're what?
This is a
leaf. They're digging some leafage.
Leafage?
Leafage. Like L-E-A-V-E-S.
But what?
And it's a lizard house.
It's a lizard house.
Are you teaching them how to dry out leaves?
It's a lizard house.
Is this part of Grandma Nancy's marijuana ring with the kids?
Yeah, she makes them grind it up into her stew, and then she makes pot out of it.
I think you're serious.
We're rolling some cigars later, Italian cigars. That's what's in them.
Okay.
Don't tell anybody the secret.
Yeah, don't tell anyone the secret. And there you have it. Live on Easter 2010. Nice. Madeline, what is that?
Broccoli Rob Pie.
Broccoli Rob,
R-O-B?
R-O-B-E. Oh, R-O-B, R-O-B-E. It's like a... Yes. It's like a feeding frenzy. It's like a freaking buffet. Wow, look at that. You even decorated the cake?
Yeah, man.
No, piss her off. Make it 82.
81 plus.
Lights, don't go anywhere. Lights. She got to pee.
I got to pee.
It's tough shit.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Said,
happy birthday, dear friend. Happy birthday to you.
Play ball.
Whoa.
Hey, Fran.
Okay, now go pee.
Now you can go.
Thank you.
Yeah. What did it pass?
No, that's the front door, Aunt Fran. That's not the bathroom.
Yes, it is.
The Alzheimer's must be kicking in again. Don't take a piss in her bedroom, please. Not good. Yeah, you're gonna lose, Shana. Madeline, the kids are screaming so beautifully. You made rice pudding?
Of course. You come for dinner. There's always rice pudding on the menu.
And leg of lamb. I feel very special.
Yes, you're very special.
Yeah, special Ed. Don't laugh at that. That's not funny.
You ride the little bus?
No, the short bus. I even stole a Christmas glass for my milk to go with my FF class red velvet cake. Nice.
Ready for FF class position? Activate.
Alfred, you're late.
My zipper's open too.
All, right. All the way back. All the way back, kids. All the way back. There you go.
We are now in official FF mode. Post dinner. This is the life. Kids are screaming. The old people are doing the dishes.
And guys,
nice.
Thanks.
The old people.
Get up on the dishes.
Early signs of Alzheimer's with the senior family members has indeed set in. Dave, I think they're trying to get your attention, Dave. Fran and Nancy. Yeah, bop to you too, Aunt Fran. Hello. I'll call you in the nursing home, all
right? Yeah, right.
The killer rabbit. That is an FF class killer bunny rabbit.
It is taller than me.
It's a 2-pound bunny.
It's diamond.
I'm sure it's good cheap chocolate,
this
too.
This should be illegal.
Yeah, I know. Good thing I didn't buy four of them. That was a rice pudding belch.
I know.
It was good. You smelled it? Knock it off.
We put it on the driveway and we let all the kids stomp on it.
Yeah.
Kill the bunny.
Kill the bunny. Kill the bunny.
Here goes the bunny.
Oh! His head came off. And his ears.
Next year we're getting firecrackers.
You want to...
Yeah, we're going to fill him with firecrackers and just let him go.
How about gasoline?
Gasoline will work too.
Holy crap. This place is a mess.
Thank you.
And I don't have to clean it up.
You missed the spot.
Are you filming?
Now I am.
All right, hold on.
Nancy, yes. We made you a good scullery maid.
Years of practice,
yeah. And let me say, Nancy, when Rich Sr. was bad, you used to hit him with which shoe, the left or the right?
The right.
Was it?
Both.
You used to wing
it? And if she missed, she'd tell you to bring it back so she can try again.
Is that true?
And if you don't believe me, ask my daughter, she'll tell you.
Nancy, is that true? You made them retrieve the shoe?
Madeline! When your grandmother would yell at you and throw a shoe at you, what did she tell you? She missed.
Pick it up, bring it back to me. And then she would throw it at us again.
Is that true?
Yes, it's very
not
true.
Not my shoe, my slipper.
No, it was a shoe, and it was a brush, actually. A hard brush with a hard thing at the bottom. And she'd chuck it, and then if she missed, you had to pick it up and bring it back to her until she...
How was the accuracy? Was she pretty good?
She wasn't that good, but Dad, if Dad threw a shoe at you, you were getting it. You never had to bring it back.
And I didn't miss.
And this exhibit at the People Museum shows the Madeline species. I didn't say feces. I said species.
She only has one shoe on.
She also has a load in her pants. Isabella, can I ask you a question?
What's more chocolate?
can I ask you? Do you? Isabella, I gotta ask you something. Wait, look at the. Wait. She had chocolate. Isabella, do you run 32 bit? Or 64-bit applications on your Barbie PC. Rich, what did you do to the kid, Rich?
She wants chocolate.
What's going on over here?
Beat me up.
Who is she?
It's grandma abuse.
No. Show grandma's nose.
Grandma abuse.
Shows. No. Where's grandma's nose?
No. Madeline. No.
No.
I'm going to get a black eye now.
No, you have to say a non-Caucasian eye. Be politically correct. Roundball.
I do roundball to you.
Isn't that a type of amphetamine? Rich, can't get roundball on Sis Trunk's feet?
Oh, yeah.
It's a good cheap pie, right?
Yeah.
And Frank, we're trying to suck the brains out of the kid's head.
We were having dinner, and through dinner, this thought kept coming through my mind. You know, I was thinking of the Xbox games, and the zombie games. Isn't that what really Easter is about, Dave? Celebrating the rebirth of a zombie?
Well, let's see.
Are you rationalizing that Jesus H. Christ, for a period of time, technically was a zombie?
Well, let's think about this. He died on Friday, and on Sunday, he wasn't in his tomb anymore, right? That's the whole story.
That is the story.
Okay, so the whole premise of the holiday is that he rose from the grave to join his father, right?
Right, or it's a hell of a joke.
Okay, is it possible he rose from the grave and like said something like a phrase like, brains?
Exactly. Let me tell you something. I play a video game called Left 4 Dead, and if I see a zombie rise up from the grave, I'm supposed to shoot him or
shoot
hack his head off
with a
chainsaw. And here we are celebrating a guy who basically was a zombie.
Do you think he could have eaten the brains of anyone like hanging outside the cave?
Possibly.
I'd be hungry. Hungry enough.
Well, 3 days. Dave, you're in the Marines. I'm sure you were on strict rations. 3 days, you're pretty hungry.
Yeah, you're starving.
Would you eat some brains if you had to?
Whatever you gotta eat to survive.
This could be a whole new twist on the whole, you know, from a theological standpoint here. It's a highly intellectual post-dinner conversation.
I'm kind of interested what your subscribers and readers have to say about this.
What if Jesus Christ was, for at least a 3-day window, a technically classified to today's standards as a zombie?
Could it be a zombie? I mean, there's all these other religions, you know, in Haiti, they believe in the rise, and they're afraid of zombies. What about
Lazarus? Was he?
Lazarus.
Yeah, they got him back from the dead. Lazarus. Was he technically a zombie, but did he have his memory intact? I don't know. And did he say brains when he awoke? Because if he said brains when he awoke, I'd get the F out of there.
But you know, in movies, that never happens.
Yeah. I just hate when they're in a really horrific situation, they grab the flashlight instead of the shotgun.
Right. Or close the door into a sealed room that they can't get out of.
Right, yeah. What's the deal with that?
What's the deal with you running? And they still catch up with you when they're walking.
Yeah, I never understood that. Or you're running and you fall. Why does everyone always have to fall?
Right.
And it takes them about 20 minutes to get up.
I don't think I've fallen from running since I was about 3.
Yeah, good point, Dave. I don't know. Zombie infestation. I do think about that on a fairly regular basis.
Mm-hmm. Something to look forward to. Stay tuned for next Easter.
Yeah. We'll continue this high-level, cerebral, granular conversation.
Circle of life.
The cereal or the board game?
I don't know.
Yeah, this is a doctoral-level study, though.
Absolutely. We should write it. Maybe you should have your son write a report.
Yeah, a thesis on it.
Or maybe even a feces. It just kind of rhymes.
The thesis of feces.
Probably a shitty paper. Ah! A zombie! Ah! Ah!
Al, I think we might have found something.
Right? Zombies? Zombies!
That's Ariel.
It is zombies. You have a tattoo? She got a tattoo? Your thoughts on the iPad?
Sucks. Sucks. Sucks.
Oh!
No flash player, no keyboard. I'd rather have a notebook.
What? Holy crap, she can talk? I didn't know.
Oh, yeah, she can say
something. Holy, that's unbelievable.
What's that?
What the heck was that?
What's the lion say?
Wow, that's pretty good.
No, not the kitty. What's the lion say?
Do it again.
Good girl.
Hey, good zombie training for her, too. Nice.
Wait.
We're here with Rich Sr. Rich, it's a common fact that we men need a safe haven in your wonderful home, a place where we can get peace and quiet away from all the little brats. Cute clip of Alyssa.
A man cave.
Yeah, yes. Is it called a man cave?
I'm working on one right now.
Let's see.
We're
your
building it now.
The man cave is in progress. Let's do a quick tour.
Just watch your legs don't fall.
Shout out to Joey D. All right. show us what you look. The man cave workers are indeed in progress. Beautiful gentlemen. Let me shut the freaking door and isolate the noise. Are we gonna noise proof this place?
Yes.
No, I'm serious.
I am. It's gonna be all soundproof.
You're gonna soundproof it. So you've extended the garage.
Just so I can have this room.
So this is gonna be the private script. We can watch porn in here?
That's it.
Really, an 8mm?
That would be in black and white with old fuzzies.
Yeah, but it wouldn't matter from all the wine that you're brewing.
Yeah, right.
So this will be the space. Where's the TV gonna be?
Oh, I'm thinking on this wall.
On this wall.
They put a drop screen.
No, you're gonna put a screen down.
Yeah.
And I see you have the Rhine Gold. How old is that, Rich?
That's gotta be 50 years old.
Does that still light up?
Yeah.
Light that sucker up. Can you give it some juice? Now we're going to go way back in time.
Huh? Is that cool?
That's perfect for the man cave.
Wait.
What else you got? You got prices? Yes,
that came out of the same bar that the thing came out of.
Hey, Rich, let me ask something. Can we get, like, scantily clad barmaids to work here? Can we have, like, our own staff?
I'd like to.
I have my own staff.
Knock it off. There you have it. Rich Sr. and the Man Cave in progress. More to come. Stay tuned.
Probably 2 weeks.
Nice.
Big finish.
Aw, Dave. You set it up for bunny porn? This is like sacrilegious in the Man Cave, but it's still pretty hot.
Happy Easter.
And there you have it. Easter 2010, Alfred.tv. Stay tuned. More to come. Whatever. Bye!
Sexual!
Knock it off.
Welcome to Alfred.tv.